Me, Myself, and I, Beyonce, Dangerously in Love album, 2003. If I ever had to choose one song to listen to for the rest of my life, it would be this one. Why? Easy, because this song presses a button in my inner self no other song does. It is kind of an unexplainable relationship. In its nearly 5 minutes length, it touches so many things inside of me, to the point of having a mental breakdown once over this song. In the song, Beyonce narrates the failure of a past relationship and the blossom of love, confidence, and self-respect as a result of it. But the curious thing about my relationship with this song is that I've never been through a breakup, nor even a relationship. So why can I feel attached to a song that transmits feelings I've never experienced on my own? Philosophy must have an answer to it. Throughout history, different philosophers have stated the value of music in our personal development. Plato, one of the most influential philosophers of humankind, opened up about music and lyrics being like a moral law. For him, music spreads the wings of imagination, turns sadness and apathy to charm, and brings joy to everyone and everything. Centuries later, father of modern philosophy, Immanuel Kant, talked about music being the art of expressing and sharing emotions, feelings, and sensations. For both philosophers, music is something therapeutic. It enables us to get to know ourselves better and to understand us, to develop empathy towards others, and to live future experiences by looking up to other ones. Science has also been trying to decipher the process of creating a feeling using music. There's no general agreement, but there are some quite interesting theories. And a study from the University of Berkeley has stated that these feelings and connections we have with the songs are not what we think they are. Apparently, they are just our expectations on where the song is melodically going. We like better the songs that reach the point we want them to reach than the ones that don't match our expectations. Another study from the University of Harvard states that music creates similar neural connections to the ones that are created when certain emotion is going through, such as joy, sadness, or anger. And that may be why, when I listen to a Nicki Minaj song, my brain activates something that makes my bad bitch to come out. Anyways, whether you like better the philosophical or the scientific explanation, I encourage you to never stop listening to music, to keep hyping that Rihanna song that comes on shuffle, to never stop crying at that Adele song of yours, and to always dance to that Maroon 5 song. But most importantly, keep listening to music. Because what is life without music? Thank you very much.